physicians, Dr. Thomas Turton, Dr. Edmund Pellegrino, and Dr. John Harvey, to develop a health care network for the Archdiocese. The network continued to grow through the years, and today is comprised of over 300 volunteer health care providers working in private practice, hospitals, and clinics. The mission of the health care network is to provide the poor and uninsured with access to quality, specialized health care. Patients in the network are referred from community-based clinics to network specialists. Our providers come from 35 different specialties, and last year alone, we provided over 5,600 patient visits and $14.2 million worth of pro bono health care. Thank you, Dr. Turton. For providing outstanding pro bono healthcare services. Dr. in this parish, Little Flower, where he attended grade school. After graduating from St. John's College High School, he attended Georgetown University for his bachelor's degree, University of Maryland for School of Dentistry for his dental degree, and Columbia University College of Dental Medicine for his orthodontic training. He's an active member of the American Dental Association and the District of Columbia Dental Society. Dr. Tagani is a fellow in the American College of Dentists and International College of Dentists. For 10 years, he was clinical instructor and postgraduate orthodontic studies at the Washington Hospital Center and Children's Hospital. His current involvement with the healthcare network began in 1997. He is very active in Little Flower Parish, including coaching CYO teams, serving as past president of the Home and School Association, and on the Finance Committee, Social Concerns Committee, School Advisory Board, and Parish Council. However, his most significant achievement is clearly his family, chaired by his wife, Kathy, and ruled by his children, Elise, Stephen, Lauren, and Alexis. Ladies and gentlemen, the John Carroll Society Pro Bono Healthcare Award is presented to Dr. Stephen Tagani for providing outstanding pro bono healthcare services. Ladies and gentlemen, the John Carroll Pro Bono Healthcare Award is presented to Dr. Frank Sirianni was born in Hanover, Germany, to his German mother and U.S. father, stationed there and relocated to the United States in 1956. He attended Catholic school in Maryland, where he continued to learn English under the patient tutelage of Sister Helena. He and his mother became naturalized citizens in 1959. Father Sirianni served in the U.S. Air Force, then received a Bachelor of Arts degree in English, German, and History from St. Edward's University in Austin, Texas. He taught for several years at an inner city high school in Austin. God's call for him to become a priest grew, and Father Sirianni responded by studying at seminary in New York, graduating with a Master's of Art in Theology. He was ordained in 1978 by Cardinal William Baum, and was assigned as parochial vicar at St. Mary's Parish in Rockville, then at St. Philip at the Apostle in Camp Springs, Maryland. He received permission from Cardinal James Hickey to enter active duty as a chaplain with the U.S. Air Force in 1982. His active duty assignments included posts in many states, with overseas deployments to the Republic of Panama, England, Germany, Egypt, Tunisia, and Bahrain. After retiring as chaplain from the U.S. Air Force, as a lieutenant colonel, Father Sirianni was assigned as parochial vicar to the St. Jean de Chantal Parish in Bethesda. He currently serves as parochial vicar at the St. Stephen Martyr Parish in Washington, D.C., where he serves as chaplain to George Washington University Hospital, ministering to the needs of the infirm. Ladies and gentlemen, the John Carroll Society and Senior Periacal Award is presented to Father Klaus Sirianni for providing outstanding service in healthcare ministry. Outside his dental practice, Dr. Service to us here today, and for the work you have done throughout your ministry. Congratulations.
We have one more reflection to be given by our cardinal. I want to use this occasion to thank him for his many years of service. First and most significant thing, though, is in the diagnosis to get it accurate.
it's accurate to say that the diagnosis that we face today is something that we as a church addressed 20 years ago, and I think quite successfully. But what we now need to do is be attentive so that there is no reoccurrence of that illness. There's no reoccurrence of what brought about our initial situation. I'm very happy to say that when you look at any of the discussions today about the illness, the wound that we as a church are dealing with and recovering from, that we're talking about a wound that was 20 years ago. However, one of the things we also have to be alert to today is that while that charter and while all the things that were put in place those years ago are in fact working, we do have a need to be alert that we continually keep applying that medication. Anyone who's ever had a prescription that says on it 5 refills knows that you have to take it. Otherwise, your doctor will have said, continue on this medication. We have to be alert that we're doing that. But there's a new element today, and that is we want to make sure that whatever we're doing also involves patients. It's not enough that we have in place all the things that we need to do to see that our healing continues to go forward. But now we have to be very careful that our spiritual doctors, our bishops, that there's a mechanism in place for a protection against a malpractice. And that's part of where we are today. But I think the most important element, and this is something that I reinforced by talking to some of the doctors here yesterday and today, and that is when there's been a wound that's been addressed, when you're taking your medication and you're making sure that all the steps are being followed, that you also get back on your feet. That the days when we simply say, stay in bed for a couple months and you'll be well, are over. The doctors keep saying, get up, get on with your life. And I think that's what we're seeing in our church today. Isn't that what this manifestation is all about today? The ordinary work of the church goes on. And in that work, the work of laymen and laymen, the work particularly here represented in this mass of doctors, of medical professionals, of nurses, of everyone engaged in that whole world of healing, that work just has to continue on. Just like the work of teaching has to continue on, and the pastoral ministry has to continue on. And in that comes that healing, that restoration. Granted, we will still always need to be alert, attentive, we still always need to take the medicine. But at the same time, we need moving forward with the life of this church. And I say that as one who will now be stepping aside from this extraordinary ministry here, this wonderful Archdiocese